everyone. Welcome back to our channel. From today, I am going to discuss the various topics of biology in detail, which will be helpful for the students of class 11 and 12 and the aspirants of NEET. Today, the topic about which I'll discuss is the fundamental of biology as well as the living world. Biology is the branch of science which deals with living organisms and their vital processes. It encompasses diverse fields like botany, zoology, physiology, ecology, evolution, genetics, medicine, molecular biology, microbiology, etc. So, firstly, the question comes that what is living organism or what does the term life mean? How can we tell that one thing is alive or another is not? There are different features which can describe what a living thing is. So, we have to go through these characters. The main characters of a living organism are growth, reproduction, metabolism, cellular organization, consciousness, homeostasis, and lifespan. So, the first criteria or character is growth. Increase in mass and increase in number of individuals are two main characteristics of growth. If we take increase in body mass as a criterion for growth, then the non-living things can also grow externally by accumulating material on the surface like mountain, soil, etc. But in case of living organism, they undergo through an internally regulated growth pattern. Multicellular organism can grow in mass by cell division. In plants, this growth occurs continuously throughout their whole lifespan, whereas in animals, this growth is seen only up to a certain age. Unicellular organism grow in number by cell division, which is also a part of their reproduction. So, here the second point comes, that is reproduction. Reproduction is the process by which an organism produces an individual mostly like its own. Reproduction is of two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction involves a single parent organism, and sexual reproduction requires two parents. Asexual reproduction mainly occurs in lower organisms. For example, fungi reproduce through asexual spores. Yeast and hydra reproduce by budding. In flatworm, the process of true regeneration is observed. The filamentous algae can also multiply by this fragmentation process. In case of unicellular organisms, they mostly reproduce by meiotic cell division, that is binary fission. For them, reproduction and growth is mostly similar. But in case of sexual reproduction, two parent organisms produce sperm and egg cells containing half of their genetic information. And those cells fuse to form a new cell which generate a new individual with a full genetic set. So, these are the whole process of reproduction. The next character is metabolism. So, what is metabolism? The sum total of all type of chemical reactions occurring in an individual due to specific interaction among the different types of molecules in the interior of the cells is called metabolism. There are two types of metabolism, catabolism and anabolism. Anabolism includes all building of reactions to increase the mass of the organisms, like photosynthesis. And catabolism includes the breakdown reactions like respiration, digestion, etc. The activities of an organism are possible due to energy which is mainly produced in the form of ATP during this metabolism procedure. The next one is cellular organization. Living things are highly organized, containing specialized coordinated parts. All living organisms are made up of one or more cells, which are considered as the fundamental units of life. In unicellular organisms, atoms make up molecules, which make up cell organelles and the structure. In the multicellular organism, these similar cells form tissues like epithelial tissues, connective tissues, muscle, nervous tissues, etc. These tissues in turn collaborate to create an organ, and organs work together to form a different system like digestive system, nervous system, cardiovascular system, reproductive system, etc. Then, the most obvious and technically complicated feature of all the living organism is the ability to sense their surrounding and respond to their environmental cues, which could be physical, chemical, and biological, which is about their consciousness. All organisms, from the prokaryotes to the most complex eukaryotes, can sense and respond to the environmental stimuli. Even plants respond to the external factors like light, water, temperature, other organisms, even to touch. We, the human, can also sense our environment through our sense organs. Similarly, photoperiod affects reproduction in sexual breeders. So, all of these responses are regulated by the nervous and chemical mechanism. So, chemical integrity and nervous integrity both are necessary for all living organism. Next character is homeostasis. The internal mechanism of an organism can be performed in a particular temperature range. This temperature is called the optimum temperature range, which vary from organism to organism. Living organisms can regulate their internal environment to maintain the relatively narrow range of conditions needed for cell function. For example, human body temperature needs to be kept relatively close, about 37 degrees centigrade. So, human can maintain it. This maintenance of a stable internal environment, even in the face of changing external environment, is known as homeostasis. And the last, but the not the least character is lifespan. Every living organism has a definite lifespan comprised of the phases like growth, maturity, senescence, and death. So, these all are the indications of a living particle, which implies that living organisms are self-replicating, evolving, and self-regulatory interactive system capable of responding to the external stimuli. So, that's all for today. If you have any queries, don't hesitate to comment. And if you like the video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.